ChatGPT is dominating the news cycle and raising all sorts of questions around AI, ethics, and the future of work. We're not going to focus too much on the overall aspects of ChatGPT, but I do want to talk about how it overlaps with the analytics space. And specifically, I use ChatGPT to get data analyst project recommendations. I asked for them a few different ways, and you'll see throughout this video, I got quite a few different responses depending on the question that I asked. Today, I'm rating ChatGPT data analyst project recommendations. I'll also dive deeper into one of the recommendations and see if it can give us a really well-rounded project that we can work on.
I have ChatGPT open here in my window so you can see what I'm working on. One thing that you've probably experienced if you've checked it out at all is you'll need to log on, and also the system can get really busy sometimes. So I actually had to wait about a half an hour to get in here. But regardless, we're in here, so let's test out ChatGPT for data analyst projects and see how we might rate them. I have some different ideas of questions I want to ask, and I'm also curious if we get different answers. Let's start out with best data analyst project. So you can see I just typed it in, takes a moment, and let's see what results we get. So they're saying it depends on the specific industry, company, and goals. Thumbs up for that. I think that is a good way to look at it. There's not any one single project that fits everyone. They highlight predictive modeling, some dashboards, A/B testing, customer segmentation, fraud detection, one that addresses a specific need, business need, and provides valuable insight to the company. I fully agree with this advice. This probably isn't going to feel very helpful to you if you're looking for specific project recommendations, but it is good advice. I think they could get a little bit more specific here on what they mean. These are pretty generic advice points, but it's a fine starting point. So here we have the option. I can prompt it with something else, and it's going to remember what I've already asked it. I want to clear this. So we have a new chat up here. Let's ask it a different variation. So we asked best data analyst project. Let's talk about, let's say, a number one portfolio project for a data analyst. So this is sort of the same question we just asked, and I'm curious if we get the same answer, if we get a different answer. You notice it's thinking a little longer on this. Let's see if we get anything back on it. Okay, so we get a slightly different answer. It gives us a common project, creating a dashboard, a report that visualizes metrics and insights for a business. This could be creating charts and graphs, involve collecting and cleaning data, showcases the data analyst's ability to work with large data sets, uncover insights, and communicate them effectively. Decent answer. Definitely not as specific as the last one. Notice it's also not giving us a number one or a best. It's just giving us a common project. Certainly nothing wrong with this. I think this is more of just a general description of what any sort of dashboard project is. But yeah, it's okay. Let's clear that out and let's start a new chat. Best project for a data analyst career change. Let's see what kind of results we get this one. I'm not expecting ideally anything much different. Okay, so here we have, for career change, it specifies analyzing a data set relevant to the industry you're looking to transition into and use the insights to create a compelling story or solution. It gives us an example for healthcare, analyzing a data set of patient medical records to identify patterns, presented as a report or data visualization, and could be used as a portfolio piece to demonstrate your skills. So this is again, good advice. If you have a specific industry you're looking to transition into, then yes, definitely pick some data that's related to that industry if you can get it. Some of these are going to be a little more challenging. Patient medical records, probably not going to be so readily available, though you'll probably be able to find some form of that. I think where this also becomes maybe less than ideal advice is if you're not looking at a very specific industry, you're not going to want to go in and do a project for every possible industry that you're going to look at. You might also look at it more as a role-based thing than something that's industry specific. So if you're looking at supply chain or marketing or sales or audit, you might pick a project that's specific more to the role versus the industry. They're going to be a little bit more generic. So someone that's working in audit as a data analyst is going to have more in common with other people working in audit as a data analyst across multiple different industries versus somebody specifically working in the same role, like a healthcare data analyst that is not working in the audit field. Yes, they're going to be working with some similar data, but there's going to be more similarity on those common roles versus industry. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to clear this out. And I could leave this history in here. I'm just clearing it out. I don't need to start a new chat because one automatically starts. Let's look at top data analyst project. Again, we're asking very similar questions, and for some people they would see them as the same question. We're getting a variety of answers. So there's similarities, but there are some differences. So here we're getting more of a list of projects. Lots of good recommendations, analyzing fraud, recommender systems, A/B testing, NLP. Some of these are going to be a little bit more advanced than the typical data analyst might work on. So NLP, for instance, isn't going to be quite as common for a data analyst versus maybe a data scientist to work on. Not to say that there aren't roles that would involve them. There's certainly jobs where that would be involved. Time series analysis, that's a good one. Let's see, customer segmentation, predictive modeling. These are all good. They're not very specific. I'd say this is maybe the most generic point that we've gotten to in terms of what kind of recommendation that we got. And it's important to note the best project depends on the goals and the resources. So, yep, good advice. One thing that I think is interesting to note here is how ChatGPT interpreted this. So I asked for top data analyst project. It interpreted that as data analyst project ideas. Pretty similar. It's not really ranking them, but that's okay. As we talked about, there's not one single best answer here. But I think it is something that's interesting to note to see how it translates it. Let's clear that out again. Let's start a new chat. Let's see, let's ask number one project for aspiring data analysts. Here we have a popular project for aspiring data analysts, is analysis using the CRISP DM methodology, involving business understanding, data prep, modeling, evaluation, deployment, implementing the model in a production environment. And the project can be completed using any data set, such as a publicly available data set from a reputable source like Kaggle. It's a great way to learn and apply the skills needed to be a data analyst. So yeah, Kaggle is a great resource. I like that they tossed that in here. This is something that a lot of these are helpful points to include. This doesn't really give you an actual project. It's really explaining the data analysis CRISP DM project, a cross-industry standard process for data mining. And this might be something that is a little more involved than you might do. So yes, building predictive models is good. Assessing performance is good. Deploying in production is good. These are some of these, like especially the deployment into production, that's not something you're realistically going to do as an aspiring analyst. You're not going to be working in an environment where you have access to production. So I think this is a good description of what it interpreted as, but what it interpreted as is not the question that I asked. And that's a key thing to keep in mind, and where there's plenty of room to grow in all of these different models. And when we talk about the unique place of people in the process, that if we get a good response, it's because it's understood and interpreted our question correctly. Sometimes that means asking different questions. If I got this answer back, it might not actually help me if I'm brand new to the world of data analytics and I'm looking for a project. This is okay general information, but it's not actually something that I can fully follow through to the end. Let's see if we want to take any more. So that's the number one project for aspiring data analysts. Maybe let's take another example and change our wording a little. And let's say best analytics portfolio project. Okay, we're back to depends on the industry and the skills. Some ideas, predictive modeling gives us some specific predictive modeling examples. I like that. So we have building a model to predict customer churn, data visualization, A/B testing, text mining, fraud detection. It's well documented, includes a clear problem statement methodology and results. It should demonstrate your individual ability to work with data, use tools, and communicate insights effectively. So I asked best analytics portfolio project. It gave me analytics portfolio project ideas. Let's take this a step further and ask it some more. So we've tested out some different questions and how that changes our results. So now let's try to get deeper on one of these. So give me an example of A/B testing. see what it has to say. Can it elaborate more on that for me? So if you want to improve your website conversion rate, you decide to test a new design. This is a super common example of A/B testing. It's a good one. If you're outside of maybe the marketing space or web design, this maybe isn't going to be something that you can practically work on as a project example. So it's still generating some ideas. Let's ask it to give me a different example. Okay, so we're in the marketing space. This is really where you would tend to see most A/B testing taking place. It's going to be more common in marketing than in some other areas. But again, this is going to be a bit limited. So we're going to let it generate. I'm not going to cut it off. But then let's see if it can give us a way that we can create this project on our own. So I'm going to ask it for a data set. Data set to practice A/B testing project. Okay, there's many available online, and it's giving some examples. We have an A/B testing course by Optimizely and UC Berkeley, an online retail data set by UCI Machine Learning Repository. Cable has an A/B testing data set, an experiment data set from Google Analytics. And you might want to consider creating your own A/B test and collecting data. Yeah, that's a great way to learn. I'm not going to give it very high marks for this, but maybe to me, this just seems like the obvious example. If you can run the test yourself, yeah, of course that's better. How many people that are aspiring to be data analysts are going to have access to an environment where they can set up their own A/B testing on a website with any measurable volume that they can get that trust to do so? I think that's going to be a little bit harder to find. So let's look at these. Tell me more about number two. Let's see what it gives me. Transactions for about a year, a little over a year and a half, for UK-based and registered non-store online retail. Eight variables. Okay, this is pretty nice. It's giving me some interesting information here. Invoice numbers, stock codes, descriptions, quantities, invoice date, unit prices, customer ID, country. So they're saying it has about a little over 500,000 transactions. It can be used to practice A/B testing on different strategies. For example, you can use the information on invoice date and customer ID to segment customers and send targeted email campaigns, and then use the information on quantity and unit price to measure the effectiveness of the campaigns. Additionally, you can use the information on country to analyze performance of the campaign by region. So let me just flip back here. So I'm gonna take issue with this. If we look back at how it's described, it's a retail data set, and we see that described here. Conceptually, yes, if this was a real world data set that we were working with and we were in a real environment, we could use that information to segment customers, send them targeted campaigns, and then measure the effectiveness of the campaigns. But if I look at what's contained in here, there's nothing that actually gives me anything that would suggest there's A/B testing available, because there's nothing about different campaigns that were done that we can evaluate. And A/B testing is different than customer segmentation. So yes, we can segment our customers in different ways. We can look at how different customers in different countries spend money differently. We can look at how customers at different periods of time spend money differently. And so these are great examples of customer segmentation on maybe trend analysis, looking at different information, but this is not something that would be good for A/B testing. So I'm going to rate this pretty low. It sounds like it's probably a good data set, and it's something I might want to access, but in terms of realistically using it for A/B testing, not so much. I'd rate this pretty low. Now, ChatGPT is very clear that everything is very much in a learning stage. Not everything's going to be accurate. But I think this is also an example of just where we are limitation-wise, that it's difficult. Some of these nuances are difficult to learn and will take time. Not that they can't be learned, but it also would be kind of misleading for someone that's new to this and checking it out. So lastly, let me just ask, how can I access this data? Okay, it's going to tell me I can download it directly. Simply go to the page of the data set, look for the data folder. It's available on Kaggle. APIs through BigQuery and data.world. And then once you have the data set, you can load it wherever you want for cleaning and analysis. Can still be used for educational purposes, but is a little outdated. I'm a little disappointed it didn't just give me a link of some sort for any of these, but it's easy enough to go in and look at these. We've looked at some different things that we can and we can't do here. Overall, it's a good starting place, but it highlights the importance of understanding what you're talking about when you're looking at it. Some of this advice is more helpful than others. And because of that, you just have to be careful of how you take it and use it. Like I said, some of those earlier things I think were helpful, but other things, not so much. Some of the nuances missing. When we talk about A-B testing, this was not a good example. That's not to say that other ones wouldn't. It sounds like maybe number one and number three could be good examples. But we can't really practice A-B testing on different strategies on just this old data. That's not very practical. Whereas the other data sets, it sounds like they actually have simulated data or actual data on an A-B test run to test the effectiveness of a feature so that you could actually practice it. So those could be good options. Just have to take a little bit with a grain of salt what you do with it. It's been an interesting experiment. I will definitely come back and try this out on more things.
There's a lot of potential with ChatGPT, and I think there are areas where it can really supplement the work that a data analyst is doing. It may help you troubleshoot your code or write your code, but at the end of the day, if you're not asking a good question and understanding the context of the answer you're getting, you might get something that's completely irrelevant. I don't see that ever going away. I think that that's something that models will continue to get better at, but ultimately you have to understand why something is happening to understand if the result that you're getting is relevant. And that's where the real value added, the human experience piece of analytics comes in. If you can understand what the question that you need to ask is and understand if the answer you're getting is actually in response to that question and not just a reframed version of it, then you'll be really effective at what you're doing.